Okay, so I had this idea for a project, for a hobby project, to build a radio, a digital, full digital radio, an FM radio, using an FPGA. So I started a few weeks back, and I kept building blocks, and I put them together. So I end up having a FM transmitter, which transmits in the 108 megahertz band, wide FM, so it's like commercial FM, and it's using an FPGA and nothing else. So there is no RF, there are no RF components in the design. I'm actually using as a, to transmit the signal, I'm using a DAC that I constructed, just putting together a resistor ladder. So yeah, it took me a while, and I had to figure out, I had to learn how to synthesize the multiplex FM signal, which if you're interested, there are many videos on YouTube which they explain how they work. So I'll explain a little bit the chain, what's in that radio. So first of all, I'm using as a signal, as a source, I'm using my phone, my audio output, the headphones output. That goes on the board into an AC 97 codec. So it's taking a line in signal, and it's digitizing that audio signal, and it's sending it as a digital stream to the FPGA. Now, the first thing to do in the FPGA, I'm taking the left channel and the right channel, and I'm adding them together. So I'm creating the sum. That's for the mono signal, for the mono transmission, and in the same time I'm taking it, I'm subtracting them, so I'm creating left minus R, which is going to be used later. Now, in order to transmit a stereo signal, you need to create this called multiplex signal, which is the sum of the two channels. It's a pilot signal, which is a 19 kilohertz signal, which informs the receiver that the transmission is stereo, and then the left minus right is actually getting modulated with the double of the pilot, which is 38 kilohertz, and it's an AM carrier suppressed modulation. Well, I know it sounds fancy, but it's actually quite simple. So all these three things added together, the left plus right, left minus right, AM modulated with the 38 kilohertz suppressed carrier, and the pilot signal, they get added together, and that is the signal which is actually modulating the 97.5 megahertz carrier. Right, so this is in a nutshell what's there. Now, of course, I built blocks for every single step of this. I didn't write much code, so most of the blocks that I used are actually generated by the tools, like a digital DDS, digital signal synthesizer, for the pilot signal and for the double of the pilot signal. The sum, it's there are simple adders for the difference, obviously subtractor. To modulate the left minus right, I just use multipliers. All those are actually blocks which are in the tools, in the FPGA tools. I'm using Vivado, but nothing stops you to use other tools. So all those blocks, they are generated in Vivado. I only bolted them together in a top level file, which I wrote in VHDL, and I basically instantiated all those blocks. Obviously, I customized those blocks because you can customize them when you use them. And I just bolted them together in a chain, in a DSP chain. The last thing in the chain is the actual FM modulator, which again it's a DDS, which is generating the carrier, but in the same time it has a phase input, a phase input, and you can actually bring the multiplex signal there, which is going to modulate in frequency the carrier. Now, this signal from the modulator, I just brought it 8 bits wide to a R2R ladder built on a piece of PCB here, prototype PCB, and I just hook a wire. So what can be simpler than this? Now for the carrier, I use the clock for the DDS. I used a 200 megahertz clock, which was a stupid idea. I will show probably in another episode all the mistakes that I did along the whole design process. Now it's not perfect. It's working fine. You can receive the stereo signal, fairly good quality. It still has some missing things, like before you send the audio into the chain, it's supposed to be a little bit processed, as in there is a pre-emphasizer which is emphasizing I think it's actually emphasizing the high frequency, if I remember correctly. I might be wrong. But anyway, so I can create episode with each part of the design, and I can dissect the design if someone is interested, obviously. So please let me know in the comment if you're interested, and I can walk through the whole design process, and I'll show how I tested, because this thing needs to be tested. How I created test signals inside the design, so I don't have to put my phone there and hook my phone. And there is actually a very good exercise on how to choose those frequencies and how to choose the carrier. Now, I don't recommend you do this experiment on a large scale, because you can't just make transmitters. Here I'm in a controlled environment. This building is shielded, so it's metal clad around the whole building. It's an industrial building. This signal cannot escape from here. Even it's not very powerful, so it's like 20 meters away, the signal is fading away. So it's a very low power. But I do not recommend to do this if you don't know what you're doing, because it's illegal, right? So don't create pirate station unless you really know what you're doing and what you are exposed to. In most of the country, this is illegal. So I made those experiments for a short period of time in a very controlled environment. I checked outside the building if signals are not escaping with a spectrum analyzer. So please let me know if you're interested in the design, and I can talk more about the design. I can make some short episodes with the FPGA adventure. And I'll show you now a short demo. Okay, so I'll start showing you the setup. What we have here is a Z board, FPGA development board. The output for the so-called radio, it's a DAC board which I built here with the resistors, and it's just a piece of wire here. As an antenna. Now we have here a PC. We are going to watch the signal, and I have my phone here, which is going to be used as an audio source. So let me see, make sure that it's playing. So I'll just release the reset here. So now we are transmitting now. As you can see, there is carrier, and that's the carrier, and that's the multiplex, and that's the audio. So I'll just release the audio. I'll unmute the PC. That's the carrier. You can see the frequency, 97.5 megahertz. The gray band is actually the bandwidth of the channel. Now this is the multiplex signal. You can see here this is the audio band, the left plus right channel. This is a pilot for stereo, and here is the 38 kilohertz suppressed AM modulation of the left minus R channel, and this is the audio here. And just to prove that it's stereo, I'm going to move to a different room. You see, this is the stereo.